Hello, in this video, I'm going to go over MemberPress groups. Groups are a unique feature of MemberPress that allow you to quickly and painlessly set up your membership options for your site. Your users will then be able to easily compare features, prices, benefits, and more with the pricing tables MemberPress will create. Hey there, if you liked the video, be sure to give it a like, subscribe, and click the notification bell for all of our latest updates, tips, and tricks to help you get up and running with MemberPress. Now, back to the video. To start, go to your WordPress dashboard and find the MemberPress plugin, then go to Groups. Once here, click the Add New button to start creating your group. Give it a name. In this case, I'm going to give it the name of the three memberships that are going to be part of this group, but you can name it whatever you want. Now, this text box here probably won't be something that you'll use, but in case you want to, this is simply to display additional content on the group pricing page alongside of your pricing tables. Most of our users don't now that we have the change plan pop-up that we'll see later, but I just wanted to point that out before moving on. Now, the first thing I'll do is add the memberships I want to be part of this group by coming down here under Group Options to the Membership section and selecting those memberships. Use the plus icon to keep adding until you have what you want. Next, we'll go over the various options you see here. If you want this group to be an upgrade type membership, then enable the upgrade path option here. When this is enabled, members can only subscribe to one membership in the group at a time. If this option is unchecked, members can subscribe to each membership in the group simultaneously. In other words, with this setting enabled, users can't have more than one active subscription at once and will have to upgrade or downgrade from one subscription to another. Shown only after enabling the upgrade path option is the reset billing period option. This will reset the billing period to the day a user upgrades or downgrades within your group. So, if the subscription is monthly and was originally purchased on the 1st of the month, but upgraded on the 15th, the next billing date would be on the 15th instead of the 1st. While I'm talking about upgrade paths, I need to point out an important setting in the MemberPress options, and that's proration. So, let me show you where that's at. Go to MemberPress, then Settings. Open the Account tab and navigate down to the Registration section. Here, you'll see this option that when checked will prorate the subscription price when the member upgrades or downgrades. So, if your user upgrades, prorations will be calculated for them based on what they have already paid, plus the amount of days remaining in their billing period using their newly updated monthly cost. And if the user downgrades, the same is true as well. These prorations are calculated internally, so you don't have to do anything except enable this option. Now, let's get back to the group I was editing and go over what a downgrade path is. Use this dropdown to select the membership you want a user to automatically downgrade to if their subscription to any membership in the group becomes inactive. This could be from a lapsed payment, failed payment, or their subscription just expires. For this option to work, you must have the upgrade path option set. The first option here in the dropdown is default. If set to this, the user will not be placed into another membership automatically. So, if you don't want to use this feature, just leave it set to default here. It's worth mentioning that this automatic downgrade will always be free, even if the membership has a price. So, it's recommended that your downgrade path membership you set here is a free membership level. For example, if my user's membership becomes inactive, their accounts will automatically downgrade to my bronze subscription, which is free. Next is the disabled change plan pop-up. If your user wants to change their subscription at any point, they'll go into their account page, click the Subscriptions tab, and go to Change Plan. Then they'll see a pop-up that looks like this, with a drop-down menu that will include the various membership options they have to choose from. The reason why you may want to disable the Change Plan pop-up is if you don't want users to go through the upgrade process through that pop-up, but would rather have them go to a custom group pricing page that you create yourself, or the default pricing page MemberPress creates for you. If you want to use a default group pricing page, then you can just use the dropdown next to Pricing Page Theme to select a preset style for your pricing page, and you can enter in some custom CSS to further style it. Otherwise, you can click the Disable Pricing Page option here to link to a completely separate page for your pricing table. You might want to use another table type of plugin or a completely custom web page, whatever works best for you. Just put that URL here, and when the user clicks that Change Plan link we saw earlier, they'll be taken to this URL. Finally, let me outline the group price box's shortcodes. This first shortcode would be used on this page, so the content you see here. You might want to use this if you want to put some content above the group price boxes or below. This shortcode here can be used on any other WordPress page, post, or custom post type. Once you're finished, click Publish to create this group. Now your users will be able to see your membership options and manage their subscriptions with ease. If you liked the video, be sure to like, subscribe, and check out our other videos that makes getting MemberPress up and running a breeze.